start off by drinking this whiskey in a Steeler glass. I'm slowly malfunctioning. The Grinch. The game. As the Grinch, your mission is to undo WhoVille's holiday preparations with the use of your most mischievous inventions. Am I reading off the back of the game case?
Yes.
Is the original score actually stunning?
Yes.
With that being said, let's shrink down our hearts, breathe on some enemies, and ruin Christmas for innocent children.
Enter my thousand!
We start off on top of Mount Crumpet. This is the Grinch's home, his lair, where we plot to ruin Christmas with all of our mischievous inventions. But oh no, the blueprints have gone awry. However, we will be able to craft these inventions on this big computer screen. We must venture into the wild and retrieve the blueprints. Starting off in level 1, downtown WhoVille, where the kids resemble nerves from Monsters, Inc., and their attack comes in the form of a nice hug. We're given a specific set of missions to complete, and unfortunately I'm the Grinch, and WhoVille's on high alert for my legendary self.
Stop right there, criminals!
Lucky for me, I found a Who disguise. I really like how you look running with this costume on. It's kinda nice. Reminds me of Ralph Wolf in Sheep Raider. I made a video on that. Okay, now we can start easy by smashing 10 snowmen. I've actually never seen snowmen in a video game before. Can you believe that?
Another one!
We sabotage the mailroom, access the highly secured facility by staying invisible, in the shadows, rather, and making your way through interconnected tunnels like the Viet Cong. And boy, they never suspected a thing. Unless, of course, the stimulus checks get misplaced and the IRS has to get involved.
Daddy Who, could you come here, please?
Just a minute, dear. I'll be right with you.
Vandalize the mayor's propaganda. This game incorporates real art, and it doesn't stop at painting. After sneaking past these highly trained guards, we disable the security system secret agent style to do some precise sculpting work on the mayor's statue.
The Gravel Top Gang prepared to face off against the law.
Now it gets a bit tricky. In order to launch eggs into homes, we must assemble the rotten egg launcher, which requires all the blueprints scattered around the area. And this first one gave me a lot of trouble. Couldn't swing myself up to the ledge. It took like 10 minutes. Only now can we stink the residents out of their homes. Kinda like when SpongeBob thought he was ugly in the movie theater, although it was merely his bad breath that made the crowd disperse. Finally, we got to advance the countdown to Christmas. And may I add, this was a rather daunting task. 4 levels of high IQ gear puzzles. A bevy of pulls and pushes. Twists and turns. Is this the Grinch or is it Bop It Extreme? But it does lead to an epic climax. Level 2. Who Forest. The enemies get tougher, the residents get more aggressive, and there's stalactites falling from the ceiling. However, must we avoid these? It's not really that important. Anyways, we're given a new list of tasks, with the first and easiest being make the Christmas trees droop.
Contact. Target neutralized.
Not only are we ruining the outdoor decor, we're tossing fresh beehives down the chimneys, like an apiarist Santa. That's a fancy word for beekeeper I just looked up.
Bees on my head, but don't call me a beehead.
Now that the homes are vacant, I can invade them to pick up various materials, like the slime launcher blueprints, and even a cable car access ID card to get us to the top of the mountain. After reaching said top of the mountain, we simply have to slime the mayor's skis. But there's a dog guarding the entrance, so we must deal with him accordingly by shooting the snow and having it fall on him to stop him. Finally, we must replace birthday cake candles with fireworks. The fireworks are obtained by shooting these spinny targets. Although it's not as simple as one would think, considering these guards turning me into snow, and also these yodel boys slapping me expeditiously. Expeditiously. But you know on this channel, we never give up. So we push through with maximum effort.
And now, the main attraction, the cake!
What an explosive party we'll have today.
Happy birthday, Mr. President.
Level 3, the dump. Now this area doesn't have all the glitz and glam of the others, but we gotta work with what we're given. And like the previous levels, we're given a specific set of tasks, starting with stealing food from the birds. The Grinch is hungry, and this is basically his restaurant, so shoot the pizza out of the air, and then eat the pizza.
Not bad for a guy with one eye!
These little robots contain essential spare parts needed to feed this machine. I honestly don't know the purpose of doing this, but I did it anyway. Connecting all the pipes to reroute the stinky gas into Hubris Shack, whatever that is.
Whoa!
One day I'll get out of this infected place.
We must infest the mayor's home with rats by leading him into this pipe. And at first I thought I'd chase the rats into the pipe, but after jamming them all into this corner, I realized they prefer to follow Max, and it made it much easier, although tedious, because there was a lot of them. The mayor has to be God or something, because How is he everywhere? And why would he live at the dump? And if he didn't live at the dump, why would he have a pipe that goes so far from the dump into his house? The standalone mission I really enjoyed was shaving the dump guardian's head. More Sheep Raider callbacks with the minefield, except this time you just gotta jump on some items, kind of like playing the floor is lava as a kid, but quickly transitioning into a covert operation. Grab scissors from the garage, then sneak into the dump guardian's home and give him the clean fade.
I like your cut, G.
It says here, short circuit the power plant, and I didn't do that, and I don't know where I was supposed to, so I'm just gonna sing the Halo theme song.
Fatality.
Now level 4, Hoo Lake. A very Boy Scout themed area. Beautiful landscapes and vast shores to explore. Is that even a saying? Once again tasked with objectives such as putting thistles in shorts, sharp objects obtained by shooting the porcupines, and then transferring them to the boys' shorts hanging up. And after this, we gotta make our way into the gated scout camp. And considering I'm not welcome anywhere, we need a disguise. Luckily for me, there's a scoutmaster eating alone in this cabin. It's a very saloon-style encounter. It's kind of like a boss fight, but instead of defeating him, you steal his hat, then you rip off his shirt, then you pull off his pants, then you leave.
Nope.
Now we're equipped with a new outfit to complete the rest of the missions. Destroying the tents so the scouts can't go to sleep. It's very petty of him. Drilling holes in canoes, which is pretty messed up because what if they can't swim? And upon completion of that, the game sent me right to a cutscene, insinuating I did enough to move on to the final mission of getting all the sleigh parts. So that means I didn't 100% complete the game. But I did get to meet this old pirate, and that was pretty cool. He wanted me to steal the scouts' scarves, but because I didn't have the Grinch copter yet, I couldn't reach this flying guy. Now, I could have went back to each area and got the blueprints for it, but my eyes were bleeding, I was on my 11th hour, and I want to make this video.
Fatality.
Final mission. Get all 5 sleigh parts. And to get these parts, we gotta go back to each level and do some pretty fun stuff. In downtown WhoVille, we gotta chase around this truck, and when his door's open, we shoot in and the part comes out. It's kinda like TimeSplitters 2 Chicago when he killed Big Tony's cousin. Back in the forest, this guy challenges Max to a race to the ski lift. We beat him to the ski lift, and we got some fresh new skis for the sleigh. Down at the dump, we move chess pieces into the designated areas. And that opens the garage door, and I forget what part it was, but it's a part. Now back at Hoo Lake, this scout wants to shoot 10 birds out of the sky. Simple enough, we shoot 10 birds out of the sky and get part number 4. And here's where things went awry. I like the word awry. The final piece of the sleigh is located in level 5, Submarine World. And in order to access this, I had to get the final blueprint for the Marine Mobile.
My Marine Mobile!
And since I came for the sole purpose of just getting the sleigh part, all I had to do was gather some pearls for this sea creature right here, this green guy. Comment what this guy's called down below. I'm gonna know when I look it up after this. But I finally built my way into the finale. Sleigh ride. Santa's here to deliver presents to WhoVille, and that's unacceptable. So we gotta collect 10 presents in succession, for some reason. Followed by shooting Santa. And I will admit, this is one of the most creative space battles I've seen in a very long time. One thing leads to another, we kill Santa. Now all we gotta do is watch and enjoy the sorrow and the sadness. But what's this? The Whos are happy. They're celebrating Christmas. They're singing. Oh no, I'm starting to feel love now. Time to restore Christmas and finally become accepted and also friends with my enemies. Now we did return all the gifts, but what about all the drowning children with no place to rest? Or the villagers with dead trees and bee-infested homes? But I don't feel bad for the dump guardian. He still got that fresh cut. Well, that's about it for me. Make sure to drop a like on the video and even leave a comment down below if you think I'm not lame. No matter what you do, I really appreciate all the support I get with each video. Anyway, this has been the Grinch on PS1. Ultimate gaming experience. Extravaganza. Now I'm going to impersonate
a 50s radio host talking about children who drowned on the night before Christmas due to negligent supervision amongst the scout leaders. That being said, thank you so much, and this is the outro.